blind?
Ah, buzz off!
Who are you pushing around, huh? Can you imagine that? Angie thinks that guy's got more sex appeal than me. Is she in for a letdown?
Oh, come on, Charlie. Dance with me. I'll help you work off your frustrations.
You know how hot I am for a piece. Such dumb broads, nothing but losers. A guy like me here is just starving for a piece, and dancing's all they think about. Okay, it's my turn now. How's this?
Hey, it's my turn with Britt.
All's fair in love and war.
Hey, where you going?
Britt wanted to show me something.
What's that?
My collection of butterflies.
Wouldn't mind seeing it myself.
What I've got is for Tommy to look at and nobody else.
Shall we go to your place?
No way, lover. My parents are home tonight.
Damn it, mine too. Ciao.
You can use my pad if you give me some bread.
I wouldn't give you a plug nickel for that creaky mattress if you
I didn't do it in the woods.
Not a bad idea.
Oh, here you go again.
Hey, wait, Tommy!
Come on. Quiet. Watch the steps.
Is this a new discotheque or something?
Take it easy. What I'm going to show you is more exciting than any disco.
Then is it a new subway station?
Of course not, sweetheart. My Aunt Jennifer lives here.
She must be loaded.
You'll believe anything. This is the county courthouse.
Really?
And my old man is the county judge. Jump on.
Wait for me.
Jump on.
Too late. Oh. Wait for me, Tommy. Wait,
come on.
Wait.
Come on. Everything's okay.
Thank you. Oh, good morning. Good morning, Your Honor. Good morning.
Morning. Good morning. Good morning.
You're bright and early today.
To catch the worm?
Yes, of course, Your Honor. Of course. Out of bedroom.
Nature. And then he asked her to take her clothes off and lie down next to him until it was sunset. As she had occasionally done, for only one thing was missing in his education. There was only one thing that could satisfy his intense desire besides kisses and embraces and lying side by side. Chloe then timidly asked what that might be. He asked her to observe the animals of the fields and the forests, the sheep and the ewes, the cows and the bulls, how they clung to each other and leapt on each other to satisfy their lust.
Now, what did Longus, the author of Daphnis and Chloe, want to express in these lovely verses? Walter?
Well, you see, old man Longus, you see, he wanted to screw this Chloe chick. Only he couldn't make the grade, so to compensate, he wrote pornographic poetry.
How sad for you. You're missing something out of life, Walter. If you believe that that exquisite and sensitive poetry is just pornography.
Excuse me.
Maybe Thomas can enlighten us. What do you think of when you read Longus?
It's really erotic. Makes me think of sex.
Quiet. Quiet, please. Can anybody here think of another word? Angie. Angie. If you would be kind enough to concentrate for a second, you might hit upon the word I'm looking for.
You mean love, huh?
Yes, correct. Yes, love. It's time you got used to talking of the act of lovemaking, the most beautiful experience in life.
Does she look screwed out?
With words as beautiful as the act itself, and not those filthy four-letter words that make love sound like a foul and evil act, an act of depravity and sin. The way Charlie did a minute ago.
Better cut out that filthy language.
You should all think about it seriously.
Come here, Angie. Let us love. Next one who says screw pays for a round of drinks. Hey!
Play tennis too. I really hit the balls.
Get lost.
Oh, I get it. Mummy doesn't want her precious little angel talking to strange men, eh?
Oh my God, are you all right?
Come on, give me a kiss.
Oh, you cheat, you... Let
Come
me
on.
Go!
Don't put you up close, sweetheart. It's all in fun. Hey, where's my key?
Find it yourself, sweetheart.
Where the hell is it? Oh, hello, Wayne.
Angel, you finally made it.
That act of yours isn't funny at all.
Then how come they booked me overseas?
May I make a suggestion?
Sure, I'm all ears.
You should go overseas.
Hey, I can't swim.
I like you better as a corpse.
Fair enough. I'll lie down for you anytime you want me to. What's the big hurry, huh? Haven't you any pity for me? Can't you see that I'm burning with love? Just like Daphnis for Chloe. You've heard of them, no doubt. Look, I'll be a corpse for you anytime you want. If you don't say something now, I'll be forced to take my young life.
No, not right outside our front door. I'll see you, Daphnis.
Yes, but where? I don't even know your name.
Miller Meyer Hopper.
That's what I keep telling Herbert, but men simply refuse to listen. What is it, Eva? Say hello to Mrs. Holman.
Hello, Mrs. Holman.
Hello, Eva.
Where on earth were you? Your tennis lesson was over hours ago.
I had a flat tire.
She's been acting so strangely.
That's just puberty. Erica was like that at her age. The best policy is just to leave them alone.
I guess it is, but that's easier said than done.
Oh, I have to go. When my husband comes home, dinner must be on the table or else.
Just like a man. Wait a second, I'll go with you. Eva, I'm driving Mrs. Holman. Try and do some Latin homework. Ready?
She forgot to lock her bicycle again.
That's puberty for you.
Making out with your new chick.
What new chick?
My secret service is everywhere.
Come on, I just met her myself.
What do you mean you just met her yourself? You don't keep secrets from me now, do you?
But this one is different.
Oh, really? Now, what does that mean? You wouldn't have a crush on her.
Think whatever you want.
Okay. Come on, over here.
Over here.
Hey, come on, come on, pass it over.
Hey,
try. Easy, try.
Look at that chick. For her, I'd even start taking tennis lessons. She deserves a partner like me.
She's already got a partner.
That schnook, he wouldn't know what to do with her. But I would.
No, a broad like that needs a delicate touch.
Hey, watch what you're saying. That's Eva.
Eva?
Thanks.
Thanks.
Baby, can't you
Somebody had better keep a lookout in case Rasputin decides to bust in.
Let him bust in. He'll learn a few things.
Have you got a cough drop for me, Tommy?
I don't have any, Mr. Benson.
Very funny, Tommy. If you want to put one over on me, you're going to have to do better than that. Your style is a little crude and boring. That's enough for today. The time is up. Walter, would you please collect all the tests?
It's always got to be me.
And what are you submitting, Britt? Your test or your lovely thighs?
Huh?
Would you step up front?
If I have to.
Please pull up your skirt.
Isn't that immoral, Mr. Benson?
That all depends on why the individual is raising her skirt, Walter. Would you please, Britt? Oh, don't be embarrassed. We're all one happy family. Now, I wonder whether we should consider those gorgeous thighs merely as anatomy, or do they communicate something far more fascinating? Fascinating details of physical nature combining sex and science and undoubtedly advancing the great cause of knowledge. Don't you agree? All right, go back to your seat.
Hey, that's Eva there.
She's sure carrying a big purse.
Stupid. That's her sketch pad.
Well, what's she gonna do with it?
She's going to her studio.
She's studying painting?
Yeah, wouldn't mind doing some brushwork on her myself.
Let's get out of here!
The fat one's cute.
Yeah.
Hey, wait!
Eva! Oh, sorry.
Who do you want?
Oh, forget it.
Excuse me. Oh, brother, what did I just see? Oh, may I give you a hand? Oh,
thanks so much, it's very friendly.
Are you from Arabia?
Oh, no, Yugoslavia.
Oh, Yugoslavia, what a beautiful country. Beautiful rivers, beautiful women.
Oh, you hurt yourself?
I don't know yet.
Will you stop that? This is a respectable house. I'm calling the police.
Aren't you one of Tommy's friends?
No, I'm his rich uncle.
Don't look at it, please. I'm not finished with it yet.
It looks very interesting. I like your technique.
Oh, I'm not Rembrandt.
If you're looking for a superb male specimen, I'd be willing to pose in the nude for you.
All right, come in.
This minute?
Well, why not? Have you lost your nerve all of a sudden?
Oh, no, not at all. I'm proud of what God gave me.
Well... Let's get started, then. Well, what are you waiting for? Get undressed.
You mean all naked?
Yes. Didn't you say you were dedicated to the cause of art?
Yes, but it's not so simple. I feel kind of funny, like I was at the doctor's. But I never had a lady doctor. Oh, what the hell. Art for art's sake, I always say.
Would little Charlie like a glass of champagne?
Why not? Heard the stuff puts lead in your pencil.
So they say. But a man like you doesn't need artificial stimulation.
I don't need stimulation.
Hey, I think you really got talent. I'm impressed.
Oh, damn it, that must be my brother. Hide.
But where?
Go on, hide, hurry. They're out the window.
But I'm naked.
Hi, sis, would you do me a favor? Give the folks these tickets for Boney M. I can't make it, I got an important date.
With a chick?
Yeah, real sweet dish, too. Where's your roommate?
Who, Jane, or she had a late class?
Tough luck, I kind of went for her.
You wouldn't get to first base with her. Stick to your older women.
Well, I thought I heard a noise.
Zivolik!
Ostrovnya.
Come on, baby.
Say, you got a great view. Hey, where'd you get that weirdo costume? You'll freeze your walnuts in that outfit.
Keep quiet!
You're acting strangely. Anything wrong? Are you in love or something?
Oh, about those tickets.
Yeah?
May I go instead? I've never seen Boney M.
Sure.
Oh, I forgot something. Come, I'll go with you. I've got to pick up some books I ordered.
Yeah, and Big Brother gets to dig out his wallet and pay for them, right?
You're so clever.
Well, now, let's get down to business.
Yes, let's settle everything.
What do you mean, huh?
First of all, there's my champagne at $20 a bottle, and 20 more for the pleasant conversation with me. And if you can afford a little bit more, I'll... Then, because you're such a beautiful little boy, I'll make you a very special deal. We'll say only $50, okay?
What? You're a hooker, huh?
I carried her to the mattress just like a baby. She was so hot for it, she didn't even bother to take her clothes
off. Hey, you ought to be careful. If you keep on like that, you'll end up wearing it out.
Look, I'm only normal. I tell you, she went after it like it was going out of style.
Right, you tell me about it later, Superman. Let's go. It's late. Come on.
Since when are you so anxious to get to class?
Please, quiet, please. Today, I'm going to quiz you on an interesting subject. Oh. I would like to ask the following question. If you suddenly discovered you only had a few days left to live, what would be your very last wish? Don't try to be cute. Just go to your seat and pay attention for once. All right, everyone. Now, please try and concentrate. The question is, if you were in a very dangerous situation, what would your last wish be? The subject is only interesting if you take an extreme situation, such as disasters, atomic... Go and get it. Yes, you should take a natural disaster or catastrophe. Or a thing that could threaten the existence of the world. I'd like to know your last wish. Any questions? Yes,
I'd like to know what you'd do, Miss Halbach.
I would get out of this classroom by the quickest route. Would you please concentrate on the subject and save your laughter for your leisure hours? I don't find any of this funny, Charlie. What's wrong, Tommy? Run out of ideas?
Already finished.
Oh.
Oh, shit!
Is that the
limit of his vocabulary.
Well, you never know what he'll say next.
You should teach him some two-syllable words.
Tommy, please stay a second.
Huh? See you later, Lucky.
Yeah, wait for me.
I can't give you any grade for your effort, Tommy. I suppose you realize that. I'll call your bluff, though. I'll expect you tonight at 8 precisely at my place. And as a gentleman, you won't tell anybody our secret.
How come my pants aren't pressed?
Because you've worn nothing but blue jeans for months. How was I to know you were going to go elegant on us?
All right. Must you make a big thing of it? Where is he going, anyhow?
He's probably got a little rendezvous.
What do you mean, a rendezvous? I've a right to know who he's going around with.
Oh, really? Then go and ask him.
If you'd raised him properly, he'd volunteer the information. Ah, you see, that's what you get from that progressive education. Those school kids are juvenile delinquents.
Aren't you exaggerating a little bit? Our Tommy's no delinquent.
The worst cases are from good families.
Oh, I don't know what you're excited about. Our Tommy's a good boy, you know that.
I hope so. But if he turns into a junkie, I'll send him straight to jail. He hasn't my qualities.
Good heavens, no. At least I've got that to be thankful for.
Say, how did you get in here?
Why, with my key.
I'm busy.
You're hot for Eva, huh?
Oh, Eva, if you only knew.
Why don't you want me anymore?
It's all over.
Forever?
Oh, what's forever?
Well, come on, then.
I told you already. I've no time.
I'll do something really stupid.
Boo.
I will, really.
Leave me alone. I've got to go. Beat it.
If you don't stay with me tonight, I'll start screaming out loud, and your old man will see me, just as I am now.
Oh, no, you won't. Get in there. Dad, can you lend me $10 till next week?
Can't you get a little job?
Calm down.
Do you want your favorite son to starve?
Oh, you two are always ganging up on me. Always the same. Oh, what time is it now?
7:30.
Thank you. And how will my hard-earned money be used, huh?
I'm going to the movies. There's a John Travolta film on.
Oh. Movies, movies, what a waste of time. And who is John Travolta?
Give me the dough, please. I'm late now.
Oh, God, what manners.
What are you looking at?
Oh, nothing, nothing, nothing at all. I thought I saw something.
Do you mind adding another 10?
Why? What for?
You see, I lost a bet.
You were gambling?
No.
What then?
I used the word screwing.
Screwing?
Screwing.
If you say screw instead of make love, you have to buy a round.
Oh, what have I done to deserve this?
Don't be upset, darling. It's just a result of modern pedagogy.
And I want 20% interest.
Sure, have fun, Tom.
Oh, it's beyond me, beyond me. Must be Fredericks, that nuisance. Would you please open the door?
Do it yourself.
Yes.
Good evening. Don't I know you? My name's Fredericks. The judge is expecting me.
This way.
Good evening, Your Honor.
Yes,
this is my son, and,
I love you.
Come over here, Fredericks. You know my wife,
yes,
don't you?
I know your son, too.
Have a seat.
I'd rather stay.
I said sit down.
Good evening, ma'am.
Delighted.
Your Honor, I know you're very busy, Your Honor, and besides that, some friends are waiting for me.
Then make it short.
You see, Your Honor, I brought you your files.
There's something wrong with Tommy.
Why, darling, that's just puberty.
Oh. Oh, I've got it now.
What?
A crossword. To make love. It begins with S and has 5 letters.
The files, please.
Oh, excuse me, Your Honor. Excuse me.
Yes, yes.
As I was making out with that Yugoslavian baby, I suddenly looked up and saw his naked ass waving in the wind. I thought my eyes would pop. Hey, what's with you? Did you just come from a funeral or something? Or are you just trying to impress the gang with those nifty threads?
Can it. Double scotch.
Right. A double scotch? Did you just rip off an old lady's handbag?
My lordship won't speak to any peasant. Hey,
woo!
Look at that.
It looks like one of Charlie's angels.
Hello, sweetheart. You coming from the funeral with Tommy?
Let's go. Right.
What's the matter?
I've got a date that I can't keep. A really nice chick.
Who?
Mary Beck, the singer.
Say, she's not bad. I have a date tonight, too. You want to switch?
Who's your date?
You don't know her.
What's her name?
Rita Mueller.
Thank you.
A man of very few words. Why don't you keep dancing? Oh, no, not the bedroom yet. All in due time.
But,
Ah, flowers. Well, thank you. How thoughtful. Make yourself at home. There are drinks over there. Fix us something. Casanova. What's the matter? Why don't you sit down and tell me?
I'd rather stand.
How dull. Oh, you haven't even made us a drink yet.
Well, I wasn't sure what you wanted.
Whiskey or a gin?
Yeah.
Or else both.
Whiskey, please.
You love me, don't you?
I don't know. It was really meant in fun. If you were to die soon, what would be your last wish?
Ah, you wanted to sleep with me only... only if you thought that you were going to die?
Oh, no. Not like that.
Is your drink too strong?
No.
Here, take this.
Oh, God, this is embarrassing. I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh.
Not really a model of passion, are you?
Passion? Why? What do you mean by that?
After that offer, to make love. I was expecting from you at least a marriage proposal. I feel jilted.
Oh, forgive me. I shouldn't have written it. Miss Halbach, do you think a teacher should be allowed to make love to one of her own students? You know,
You mean before they are married? What did Matthias Claudius say? Love has no barriers. It knows neither lock nor key. Nor light, nor dark.
And it is without beginning nor end, and thus shall it be forever and ever.
That's good. That's very good. Oh, you must get out of here.
Why? Who is it?
Out the window.
Oh, we're on the 13th floor.
Don't be superstitious. Oh. Hello, who is that?
Me, dear.
Oh.
Why, that's Rasputin.
Yes, you can take the elevator because he always likes to walk up the stairs to keep fit.
Well, what if he forgets?
Ah, you mean you've got a guilty conscience? And Tommy, listen, the next time you invite a girl to bed, you ought to make double sure you plan to follow through, or you'll look very foolish indeed. And as for your little love message, I shall cherish it as a souvenir. Unfortunately, though, I can't grade it. It has absolutely no form or style. You're still a baby. You have a lot to learn. Only don't despair. You'll make a man yet. And now, goodbye.
Hello, darling.
At last.
Well, now, how did he take it?
All right.
Really? Huh?
Well, I think I misjudged him. He's really nice. And maybe I was a little too hard on him tonight.
It's dangerous to play with fire. Very. You know, we men are fragile. Handle us with care.
Yes, I will, darling. But I did ask you not to ring the bell before 9.
To play safe, I came at exactly 8:30.
Ah, not a minute too soon.
look at that baby. What a figure. I'd join the Navy if I got her for a roommate.
We celebrating her birthday?
Have you got any dough left?
I haven't a cent.
Neither have I.
Listen, resourceful guys like us aren't gonna let a little shortage of cash stand in the way of our having fun, are we? And anyway, I know how. We can make a little dough.
Yeah, rob a little bank.
I have an uncle who makes TV commercials. We can be extras and make ourselves a lot of bread.
Hey, that sounds great. May I bring Eva?
Which Eva?
You know, Eva the blonde.
Oh, her.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Sounds like you've fallen for that chick. Are you making any progress, or is she still saving it?
You got a date with Eva?
Yeah.
Too bad.
Why?
She can't make it today.
Oh, damn it. All that crap.
She apologizes. She's got some extra homework.
Again?
Hmm.
All right. I'll find somebody. Say, would you like to play with me?
I'm sorry. I prefer girls.
Hi. You here again?
Want to knock a few balls around?
I've got a game with a pro.
Yeah, but your pro isn't here today.
Oh, no? Since when? He comes every day.
He had a bad tooth. He had to go to the dentist.
That's funny. His teeth look like they're made of rock.
Yeah, well, maybe he took a nibble on you and chipped one.
How come you're here?
I was working out with Jimmy Connors.
Ha. Huh. I'll laugh later.
Yeah, and I thought I'd love to play around with you.
You big talkers usually can't tell one end of a racket from another, but I'll give you a chance.
Say, let's play whoever loses has to kiss the other one, okay?
That's not funny at all.
All right, ready for touchdown.
Will you stop that nonsense? It's boring.
My boredom quotient is 170.
All right, let's see your tennis quotient.
Come on.
That style shows you've never played any tennis before.
Okay, I admit it. But maybe you can show me some tricks.
Sorry, but a tennis coach must have nerves of steel.
I didn't want to play anyway.
Then what do you want?
I came here only to see you. I wanted to talk to you.
Oh, what about?
Well, to ask you a question, whether you'd ever gone to bed with Walter.
Oh. Is that what he said? Yeah,
that's what he said.
I say bullshit.
What'd you say?
I say bullshit.
Well, did you sleep with him?
I don't know. What business is it
of yours? Just because I happen to be in love with you.
You're crazy.
Yeah.
Do you know what kind of work you want to do?
No, maybe TV commercials.
It's better than tennis.
I'm playing in a film now.
Oh, really? I'd love to see it.
Come on over whenever you like. We're shooting at the Ice Palace.
Hello? Hello? Looks good on you. Are you Mark Antony?
Just one of those humble Roman gladiators.
I see. And what scene are you shooting?
Oh, well, why, the big love scene, of course. What else?
Ah, a love scene. Well, then lights.
Hey! Camera! Action! And what you need is to give the world love for me and you. Leave a light in my window. 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 Some call me foolish to lend my helping hand, but I keep a light in my window. I feel so good when I help my fellow man. I keep a light in my window. And until love and mercy shine throughout the land, I'm gonna keep a light in my window so I can ease the pain that life can bring. Help you find the peace your spirit needs. I have been sure in my heart that what you need is to give the world love for me and you. Leave a light in my window. Leave a light in my window. Soon enough.
Hey, can that be the great Mark Antony riding on his mighty horse?
I hasten to your side, beautiful Cleopatra.
Can you just see us sleeping in twin beds?
Why, twin beds? We only need one bed.
All married couples sleep in twin beds.
Well, we're not married yet.
A green field would do, too.
Well, a bed or a green field. It's the girl who should choose. She's the one who lies on it, after all.
Oh, already emancipated.
Don't get fresh.
I used to play here every summer with a girlfriend of mine.
It's very romantic. Mm. Weren't you afraid the vampires would come at midnight and suck the blood right out of your veins?
No, we never had any fear of vampires, but the wind always used to make the curtains sway, and the moonlight would cast terrifying shadows on the walls.
And the evil spirits would reach out and grab you and pull you into the dungeon and try to eat you alive. Hi-ya!
Oh, I thought you couldn't hold a chopstick and you're a kung fu expert.
You see, my dear, that was the throw Cleopatra used on Mark Antony. Don't move. Don't wear these things today. Oh, damn it. This can kill the mood like nothing else.
There.
At last. I'll never wear a bra again.
Kiss me, Walter.
it?
Not in public.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Morning, sister. I'd like to see Angie Wallace.
Who are you?
Her dear brother.
I needn't remind you, young man, this is a convent boarding school, and we only allow visitors in the visitors' lounge, and even there for only 1 hour. And we behave ourselves properly.
Yeah, yeah.
I'd like to pick up my daughter. Oh! What kind of plant is that?
I don't know, really. The florist said it was something like a sunflower.
Not here. Oh, come on up.
Hey, the visitors' lounge.
The sisters are all out. Come on.
Oh, what a break.
When I was a child, I used to sing in the church choir, and then I went to the conservatory to study singing. Everyone told me I had a real talent and should go into opera. La, 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 la. Such an exquisite voice. The teacher said only a singer with religious training could sing from the heart like that. But I had to give it all up when I entered the church. Choo-choo train,
a chuckin' down the track. Hey! Here, for you. And I smuggled in a little fire water to warm the cockles. Say, where are the other girls?
The others will be here after visiting hours. All the parents are here.
Well, here's money, right? Ah! Now, let's see some action. Hey!
The Mother Superior, quick hide!
Under the bed! I can't! I'm too fat!
No, here in the closet! Quick, hurry! Go on!
I've got closet phobia!
Bring on! Oh!
My cake!
Go on!
Now, 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 children, what's all this? Quiet, quiet, look at this disorder, how disgraceful. Father Bernard has kindly consented to visit our convent today. So I thought it would be an excellent occasion for him to sanctify this room.
Well, Father Bernard, what are you waiting for?
This is Brother Charlie.
Stop that laughing. If that young man isn't out of here in 1 second, no one will be allowed to go and see Boney M.
Oh.
Disgrace.
Man, she's just fantastic.
Gang, allow me to introduce Eva.
I tell you, I learn fast.
Hey, that's great.
She'll be the pupil, and I'll be the teacher.
If I flunk the math test Tuesday, it'll be your fault.
If you flunk, I'll marry you.
Really? You really would if I flunk?
Hey, what kind of movie is this?
Come on, get out of the way, will you?
You're blocking the screen.
I didn't know about this, honest.
No, Charlie, stop! So this is your terrific gang?
Hey!
Have you got so little imagination that you need to watch porno films?
Oh, get out of the way if you don't like it.
They all want to see it.
Come on, don't be a killjoy.
Quiet, let's watch the movie.
Shh. Eva.
I'm an idiot.
Damn it, that's all I needed.
Oh, an idiot. An idiot.
What do you want?
Open your steps. Hello, I came to get the files.
I'm busy, goodbye.
But... Hey, don't touch me. Leave me alone. No, no.
Stop this instantly. Why, Fredericks, what are you doing in my swimming pool?
Oh, Your Honor, Your Honor, I came to get the files.
I want to send to you.
Don't you want to dance?
Not now. With anyone you got to me. Moving to the rhythm, let your body feel the beat. Dancing in the streets, let your feelings hang on. Feel it all you got. Keep on dancing, sing and shout. Keep on dancing in the
streets. Where's Eva? I have to speak to her.
Well, I suppose you're the boyfriend, huh? Huh?
Yes.
Well, come in. Broken my sister's heart. Love her and we're worried about her. I don't want to have her suffer.
Neither do I.
Oh, no? Expect me to believe that?
Where is
she? It's none of your business.
Where is she?
I'm not going to tell you, so just go away.
Eva's at the castle.
Thank you.
Are you crazy?
Eva.